Hello guys. Yeah, it's been about 2 years now since I graduated my primary school, and I miss it a lot, and I thought what better way to recall about my primary school experience than deciding what the best primary school in Singapore is. So I asked a few of my friends a few questions about their primary school that they went to, and some of them were kind enough to take their time to answer the questions that I gave them. And from their answers, I'm going to rate the schools 1 to 10. Well, it's literally my own opinion, and everyone's school experience, you know, even if they go to the same school, it's all very different. It's pretty inaccurate. But let's just do it. Okay, so Methodist Girls' School, MGS. Yeah, it's pretty a well-known school. Best thing about the school, many fun activities, many opportunities, going to HDBs and perform. That's nice, actually. I like that, you know, you get to do service work. Worst thing about the school, not very free. I felt very forced to be a certain person. We had very strict rules, but on the contrary, because of this school culture, it kind of shaped me to become well-mannered and made us very guai. Guai as in obedient. To simplify things, there was very little self-discovery, and it was more of shaping us to be good students. Space for exploration, space for students to, you know, build up on their passion and all that. I mean, that's really important to me. So this isn't a really good thing about a school. Best experience in school. All the celebrations. She says that during primary 1, primary 2, primary 3, it was so fun to watch the performances. But then when she got into primary 4, primary 5, primary 6, it was more of planning these events. I think it's good how, like, the school really has, like, leadership positions, like opportunities for students to actually use leadership skills to, like, organize events and make it fun for their schoolmates, you know. And I don't know, that really kind of comes in when you go into secondary school and not much of primary school, because primary school the teachers do pretty much everything. So I think having those kind of experiences, I think it's really great for a school, especially for a primary school. Okay, anyways, move on. Very studies and values based. Not that fun because we had certain expectations in terms of how we act. Well, I don't really know what to talk about this, but I think it's good and bad at the same time, because I feel like it's important to have expectations and rules to make you more independent and a good person. And you kind of should build that in primary school, because that will never go away. Primary school is really important, especially like creating you as a person. It's the time in which you grow the most and build your character. You know, you can't really change after that. But I don't like it if it's too fixated, like if it's creating everyone to be kind of like the same person. Okay, I speak too much. She rated it 7 out of 10. It was very good as a primary school in terms of grooming you to be a good student, but for 6 years, it can be a bit annoying. Most go to MGS secondary after graduating, and 10 years in MGS, there isn't much exposure to the real world where people act differently. Yeah, so based on all this, I just feel like MGS is good as a primary school. Well, not really, because I value exploration and freedom a lot. So maybe not, but I think in terms of like grooming you and letting you be a good person with manners and all that, that is important too, you know. So I think it's really good as a primary school, but staying too long of a time here might be a little bit frustrating. I think I'd give it a... This is difficult. Yeah, 6.5. CHIJ St. Nicholas Girls School, aka St. Nick's. Best thing about the school encourages a close-knit community. Everyone calls each other 姐姐 or 妹妹, like big sister, younger sister in Chinese. Worst thing about the school, homophobia. But the worst thing would probably be elitist behavior. Okay, so I didn't know what this meaning was because my brain is a bit dumb sometimes. Well, actually all the time. But so to sum it up, elitism is apparently the belief or notion that individuals who are elites are better than others. Homophobia, I don't know. I think it's also partly because the LGBTQ+ community is still developing. It's still not like normalized yet, which I hope it would be someday. Yeah, but I just hope that people start to respect the LGBTQ+ community because it's really just normal. I don't know. I don't understand. Like, I feel like LGBTQ+ has always been here, and it's only recently that we started like talking about it actually and stuff. But really, identity is something really important to me, and disrespecting one's identity, I think it's so disrespectful. Elitist behavior. I don't know. I hope more people will understand that, like, everyone, it sounds so fake, but like really everyone is so different. You can't compare yourself to others literally because there are so many things in comparison, you know. Maybe comparing your grades might be easy, but comparing you as a person with others, you just can't compare that. I'm speaking too much, right? Best experience in school: singing in assembly, IJ song, school song, and fiesta. What's a fiesta? Okay. Worst experience in school: being left out in P3 or P4. I don't know. She rated it 7 to 8. The reason being the school itself is okay. I'm sorry, like based on my, you know, what's important to me, I'm not really liking this school exactly because I just feel like they're not really accepting of each individual no matter what kind of person they are, and that kind of sucks. I give it a 4. I mean, I don't know everything about the school, but looking at this, I give it a 4. Quite different from my friend though. Okay, so CHIJ Kellock. The best thing about the school is apparently the CCAs. CCAs are after school activities. Worst thing about the school, normal practices. I'm guessing homework are easy, but when it comes to the tests, they set it really hard. Is that a bad thing? Okay, I'm sorry. Best experience in school, dance and gym CCA. If you would like to have a really fulfilling experience in CCAs, this school is highly recommended. Worst experience in school, math classes. Rate the school 5 out of 10.
Sorry, hi, I just found this funny, so here you go.
I guess a pretty average school experience. So I give it a 5.5. Okay, I think I had another friend who went to CHIJ Kellock. Here. Best thing about the school, it was a girls' school, so everyone was just kind of chill with each other. Yeah, so I didn't really understand what she meant. So she elaborated, in girls' schools, it's more chill in general because girls in girls' school just tend to be more straightforward and everyone just doesn't really care as much about sensitive stuff. Well, I guess. Yeah, I also actually went to a girls' school for my primary school and now I'm in a co-ed school. I think definitely because, I mean, you know, girls or boys, they want to be liked romantically, so they don't really want to voice out their opinions about things because maybe they're scared their crushes would not like them because of a thing or two that they said.
I just feel like it's also because of the age. Like, we're all teens and we're going through an emotional roller coaster and like trying to figure out ourselves, and also because in primary school, you know, we love to share our thoughts, but we slowly lose that confidence sort of a thing because, you know, teachers, the school, you know, once you get a question wrong, then they just tell you you're wrong. So then you stop to give your opinions, you know?
Yeah, so like teachers, parents, you know, everyone included in raising a child. Well, I'm not much of a position to say this, but I really feel that, you know, we really need to listen to children, whether or not they're asking a question, whether or not they're giving their opinions, their ideas. We have to let them know that we're listening. Yeah, we really shouldn't look down on them. They're more than children. Wait, no, they're children. They've just gotten started, so we shouldn't just destroy it.
Worst thing about the school wanted students to be more healthy. The food kind of stopped and the drink store only sold water. Food is important to me, so this is bad.
Bro, technically you can get water from the water cooler.
Best experience in school. Just going on field trips. Yeah, I always liked field trips, you know? Though because of COVID-19, I haven't had pretty much any field trip in my secondary school experience. Worst experience in school, probably when one of my teachers shamed me in front of the whole cohort of not having my file well organized. I can't speak. Well organized, and that made me embarrassed and kind of mad at her because I didn't really like that teacher in the first place, but I got over it already. So yeah. Ew. Why would you just scold a student because her file was not well organized? Like, I don't understand. Such a petty person. She rated it 7 out of 10, saying that it was a pretty average school experience. Yeah, so I feel like for that experience where a teacher scolded her because her file wasn't well organized, I feel like every school there is that one teacher or like a few teachers are just unreasonable. Yeah, so I won't really look at that much. Yeah, I give it 7 out of 10. Yeah, so like I said, for my other friend, I gave her a 5.5. For this person, I gave a 7 out of 10. So it really depends on the individual. So this whole video is so inaccurate, but still watch this video. Okay.
Haig girls school.